In this video, I'm gonna do the postback action for this form. So when I submit this form, what I want to happen is I just want to display all the values I put in, and I'm not gonna bother with validation and stuff. I'm just gonna echo everything out and I'm gonna fill out the form properly. Okay, just to show you the most basic stuff first. So I'm gonna create this postback PHP in the same folder, HTML form, so postback. So how do I get those values now? Each element here has a name, so name of this input is name, of select is title, and so on. So I need that name, and since the method is post, I'm gonna use the post PHP superglobal, which goes like so, $_post, okay. And I'm gonna assign the values to variables and then echo them out. So I'm gonna have the title here, and I'm gonna say that's equal to post and title. And the variable can be named anything, of course. I'm just calling it title here because it makes sense. And I'm gonna copy this a few more times. So I also have a name, and I have the email, and message, and fav color, and here as well to get the values. So the name and email and the message and fav color. So at this point I should have all these values in this variable, so I can just echo them out. I'm gonna say echo and title and add a space and the name and add the break, and I'm gonna echo out the email as well and just add a break and message and add a break, and finally I'm gonna say your favorite color is and append the fav color variable. Okay, and that should do it actually. So if I just run this post, there it is. So if I fill it out, let's say Jack here, and the email can be jack@gmail.com, message I am Jack, and favorite color green, let's say. And if I submit this now, I am taken to postback PHP, as you can see in the URL. And I get all the values here. So Mr. Jack, jack@gmail.com, I am Jack, and your favorite color is green. So it's all good. I am getting all the values from the form and displaying them. Okay. And instead of having a separate action, you can have the form and the handling done on the same page. And to do that, I'm gonna create a new PHP file, and I'm gonna call it same page form. And I'm gonna copy the whole post PHP into same page form. Okay, I just need to make a few adjustments. Since the handling is gonna be done on the same page where the form is, I'm gonna change the action to an empty string, which means the same page. And I also need some way of knowing when the form has been submitted, because when you first request this page, you're just gonna get a form. So I need to know that the form was actually submitted, and for that I'm gonna add a hidden input field here with the value name actually of submitted and the value of true, and here on top of the file I'm gonna have PHP tags. And as I said, I need to check that the form has been submitted actually, because the first request is just gonna show the form. And for that I can use the isSetPHP function, which checks if a variable has been set. So I'm gonna say here if isSet, and I'm gonna pass that submitted, so post submitted. So if that was set, then I'm gonna do the rest. Let me just have some space there, okay. And I'm just gonna do the same thing, but on the same page, so I'm just gonna copy all of this and paste it here. Shift-Alt-F to format in NetBeans. Okay, so there's this hidden type submitted, and this hidden is usually used when you want to pass some information that you don't want to be seen in the form, such as also an ID of a row in the database table or something, okay, or something like this. So if that was set, then I do the same thing as I did when I had the handling form or in a separate file. So if I run this, first I get the form, and if I fill this out, let's say Bob Gmail, I am Bob, and red, let's say, and submit. There is a problem. I have a problem here in the an error in the syntax. Okay, just let me just refresh this page. So Bob, and the email can be Bob Gmail, I am Bob, and red, and submit. And here are the values, I'm getting them back. And as you can see in the URL, I am still on the same page as the form. So once again, the same thing as before, but on the same page. Okay, that's it for this video. See you in the next one.